The candidates who are preparing for the UGC NET Electronic Science, it is a very good news to you to crack your JRF exam in the 2020. Why? Because the UN Academy launched the Electronic Science complete course for the UGC NET exam. So if you want to crack the JRF in this 2020, then definitely you have to take the subscription plan under this UN Academy. So coming to the subscription plan, you will be having the structured course and the interactive live classes will be there. And you will be having the live tests and the quizzes also will be there. So due to all these points, you are going to get a very good clarity in the conceptual way to clear your exam in a perfect way. So these are the subscription plans for 1 month, 2100, and for the 3 months, 6 months, and 12 months. So here the different subscription plans are there. So the candidates who wants to subscribe this complete course for the UGC NET Electronic Science, then you may subscribe here any one of these plan. And here the referral code is also there. So it is a referral code you have to use, that is Ashwini K, ASWYNIK. So if you use this referral code, then you are going to get the total 10% discount on any one of this subscription plan. And now while coming to the present content of the video, here in the official website of the University Grants Commissions, on 22nd July 2020, they released one notice regarding the guidelines for the scheme of amended guidelines for the scheme of Maulana Azad National Fellowship for minority students with effect from 2019 to 20. So if you click on that one, then you will be directed to the amended guidelines here. So the amended guidelines for this fellowship from which is going to affect from 2019 to 20. So we will see what are the amendments they did in the notification. So coming to the eligibility, a candidate has to fulfill the following conditions to be eligible for the award of this fellowship. He or she should belong to one of the minority community, just like the Buddhist, Christian, Jain, Muslim, Sikh, and Parsi. And coming to the prior clearance of UGC NET or joint CSIR UGC NET examination will be a prerequisite for award of this Maulana Azad National Fellowship for minority students for MPhil and PhD programs. And coming to the third point, the eligibility conditions will be as per the notification for UGC NET and joint CSIR UGC NET examinations. And the minority community guide candidates who have already secured admission and qualify the NET examination will be given the first preference, right? So the candidates who already admitted in the PhD program and now applying for the fellowship by this NET qualification to the Maulana Azad National Fellowship, then the such type of candidates will be given as a first preference, and such candidates will be required to join fellowship within 3 months of the issue of the JRF award letter. The date of commencement of the fellowship shall be the date of declaration of result of UGC NET JRF and joint CSIR UGC NET JRF, or else the date of joining, whichever is later. Coming to the next one is, in case the sufficient candidates who have already secured admission are not available, then the candidates who have not yet secured the PhD or MPhil admission will also be selected in the order of merit in the NET examination. Such candidates will be eligible to receive fellowship under MANF subject to the admission for the MPhil or PhD in research institutes, and the validity period of the offer is 3 years with effect from the date of issue of the JRF award letter under the scheme. That means if you got the JRF award letter on one particular date, so from that date, within the 3 years, you have to take the PhD or the MPhil admission in any one research institute. That is the meaning of that point. Then, and the next one is, a scholar is eligible to receive only one fellowship at a time. The scholar is required to declare that he or she will not accept or receive any other monetary benefit, scholarship, fellowship from any other sources. So it is a one more point. So next one is, a scholar who doesn't complete his or her research work during the period of fellowship shall not be eligible to apply again under this scheme. Similarly, a scholar who has completely or partially availed any fellowship earlier shall also not be eligible for fellowship under this scheme. And next one is, employees of any university or college or educational institution, central or state, UT government, shall be excluded from availing fellowship, even if they are on study level or UOL to pursue the MPhil or PhD course. Okay, it is also the very important point. The employees who are working in such type of education institutions are excluded. Okay, that means they are not going to get the fellowship amounts. So mode of the selection, total of 1,000 slots available under this scheme. The 750 will be allotted for the subject under National Eligibility Test, that is JRF, of UGC, and remaining 250 for the science category students through the CSIR UGCNET JRF joint test for science streams. The NET is held for twice in a year, and 500 selections will be made from the each NET. Okay, and 30% of the fellowship shall be earmarked for women students, and remaining 70% will be under the general category. Clear? So these are the detailed notification and the detailed amendments for the Maulana Azad National Fellowship. So I will put this link in the description box of this video. For accurate and more details, please go to the description box of this video and click on that link. Then you will be directed to this notice. Then go through this one clearly. Then you will come to know all the details. Right? So please share this video to your friends or colleagues who are looking for such type of notifications or for such type of fellowships. And please subscribe the channel to get the more notification, and after subscribing, tap the bell icon. Thank you.